some people don't actually believe that Seamus exists, that he's just a figment of my imagination. To be totally honest, it's not that far away from the truth. Anyway, good evening. Welcome to the programme. Thank you very much for joining us. We'll go straight into our first item, and we're going to talk about those 40-year-old teenagers. So these are people that are maybe still playing computer games, and the question is, will they ever grow up? Have you noticed maybe the number of people who dress exactly like their children? You'll be thinking to yourself now, yes, I have seen people that do. They dress like skaters, or they wear clothes and jeans that perhaps are aimed at the younger market, but is it okay? And perhaps even worse, you can still find them eating junk food and playing on their PlayStation for hours on end. But maybe you're thinking, you know what, that's okay. If they are happy, then that's fine. Each to their own. Or perhaps you're maybe thinking that we're witnessing a delusional generation. That's a big word. Producer Seamus definitely put that in. We have two youngish ones with us tonight, Fionola Meridith and Nick Garbutt. Fionola, always a pleasure. How are you?
I'm good. I'm glad to be described as youngish.
Youngish. I thought that was it was the right amount of being polite without being over the top and being out of
without
character.
Without being delusional.
And Nick Garbutt, I'm not sure what we'll say about your age.
That is a bit delusional, isn't it, Vinny?
We are streaming on Facebook tonight. If you would like to go and watch, you can do that. It's on the BBC Radio Ulster Facebook page. Or if you don't and you're thinking, why would I want to see your ugly mug, then I totally understand. We're also joined by Linzi Conway. Linzi, always a pleasure. And I actually mean it this time.
Thank you very much, Stephanie. Thank you.
Well, look, first of all, Fionola, we'll start with you. These are sometimes people that maybe thought they wouldn't get to adulthood and they would live their life as these forever young legends.
I don't know if they ever planned it that way. I mean, as you say, we all know people who dress that way, who behave that way. And you do wonder, you know, was it a conscious decision to be 40 years old and having their jeans somewhere down around their backside and their boxers sticking out the top and playing all these computer games? You know, of course, it's
Nick,
totally up to them.
Nick, I think
totally
she might be talking about you there.
I never would say such a thing about
much,
Nick.
I very much doubt it. I take a very different view, actually, because I would actually be old enough to remember when, as soon as men got to maybe 45, maybe 50, they were compulsorily dressed in beige. Do you remember that?
Yeah, well, that's true.
And I think that it's fun and good for people to act how they feel rather than their actual age.
Well, that's fair enough. I've looked at the Facebook feed here, and the first question, our first comment is mutton dressed as lamb. So is that what you think? Ooh. Is that, it's maybe a bit controversial to start off with that, Nick, but is it people trying to pretend they're something they're not, or is it people just behaving and acting how they feel comfortable and what fits them?
I think it's how they feel. I mean, I don't know. I can't speak for people I don't know and have never met, but I should imagine it is. Because I think a lot of the time we forget how old we are. We just get a bit of a shock when we look in the mirror in the morning, don't we?
Well, you've just forgotten.
Forgotten. God, did I look like that now?
But what happens though if the older generation or one of those other generations, need to be careful here, they're very close at this table, if they refuse to grow up, then the younger generation, then they're kind of kept in this weird kind of limbo land.
Well, I don't know. I mean, I think, is it not okay for people who are over 40 to go out and party and
you know,
go
where
drinking
I think it's not
and
okay.
Have
it's,
fun?
It's really not okay for the kids. I think, you know, if you are trying to be an eternal teenager, and I get what you're saying, Nick, I felt a bit bad there as I'd been judging people with their boxer shorts. But, you know,
I'm sorry, Nick, I have to admit, I didn't notice on your way in, but we'll all be looking on your way out. Sorry for that. Keep going.
Yeah. You know, I think it is hard for teenagers if their parents are dressing like them. I think it's really embarrassing for them, and that's where I think some of the difficulty could arise. Whereas if people are just dressing the way they want to dress, sure, that's fine. But interesting you said mutton dressed as lamb, because that is a phrase that's normally aimed at women rather than men. And I'm not saying that you were doing that, but you know, if you think of what we've been talking about so far, we have been talking about probably stereotypically men with their computer games and their Ramones t-shirts and this, that and the other. I was trying to think, what would a female equivalent be? And, you know, do you think the first thing that sprung to mind? Those women who are maybe around about 40, who have a bed full of, I just have to say they're probably single women, have a bed full of stuffed toys, you know, like cuddly toys. I've definitely come across that.
Yes, but that's kind of the other side of it. So that's people that refuse to grow old and to get mature in terms of out of their childhood instead of trying to be a hip, cool teenager.
Yeah, still part of the same thing, isn't it? Still trying to sort of hark back to some idealised, nostalgic... I think maybe that's actually what a lot of this is about wanting to get back maybe to the innocence of childhood, the lack of responsibility. Maybe it's just a fleeing from the responsibilities and the demands of adult life.
I know exactly how they feel.
It just came to me there.
Lindsay, we're going to talk to you mainly about A-levels in a moment or two, but do you agree with either of these two fine people?
Well, the mutton dressed of lamb one sort of, is something that I could probably, comment on in a minute, because I think I'm sort of at the stage now where I'm having a bit of a crisis, in relation to what I can and can't wear, brought on purely from the fact I've got a 16-year-old in the house, that's probably helping dictate to me certain things
Good
that
luck.
I can and can't wear. So that is a challenge at the minute. Yes, definitely.
I think it's one of those things, it's quite subjective, obviously, Nick, and people want to be comfortable how they feel. But what do you say then, and I'm not necessarily addressing this to you, although you are quite young and hip. Can I ask what age you are?
I'm 58.
Really?
You're not, Nick. I don't even believe that. 58. Well,
no, you're not. Well, God, don't look at Facebook now, because I look probably older than him, and I'm not. I don't know. Well, maybe this is another point.
A good
then.
Paper round, Nick. A good paper round.
If you are kind of dressing a bit younger than a 58-year-old, maybe that's helped to keep you young, because you do not look that age.
I don't know. I mean, I think you can choose, can't you? I mean, people make choices about how old they feel and how old they are and what they do. And I think that's fantastic.
Yeah,
I think it's right. Yeah. And you don't want to be constrained either. I mean, look at someone like old Willie Nelson still, making music, and he's 80 something, So why give up and have a beige existence? That's true, once you hit a certain age.
Yeah.
Is there
a fair point, though, when you would say, in terms of the millennium, people quite often, you alluded to this earlier, Nick, they don't realise what age they are. They don't think about it too often. And maybe when they do, they think, well, what age am I? I must be whatever age I was around then. So I must be, whatever.
Yeah, I think you sort of mentally stick at a certain age and you think you never really get until, of course,
I'm still 21 in my head.
Yeah,
so then you get the look in the mirror, you think,
it's
okay.
The one that gets to me, actually,
is when you see yourself in Lycra. At a certain age, if I'm out running, I'm thinking, this is what I think I look like. And then you get a glimpse of yourself, in a window as you're passing by. And it's a bit frightening.
The answer to that is never wear.
You could say you're
painting a very negative picture of getting older. And once again, I'm being very careful because you're all three of you are very young.
I think it is down to a state of mind. I really do. I think, there are young people who have an older mindset, and yet there are older people who have a younger mindset.
But is that in itself a bit sad? For example, Tim here is saying, I'm 46 but dressed like I'm in my 20s. It's not my fault if kids today are suddenly wearing Metallica and Iron Maiden t-shirts and leather jackets for some unknown reason. So there's a fashion
too
thing
right,
here.
Too right, yeah, yeah. And I think as well, with music, certainly my eldest son is really likes the music that I like. Mm. You can't beat the golden age of music, sort of late 1960s. He loves Cream and Jimi Hendrix.
Do you know
Hendrix
what I think
as well,
it is to do with your fashion senses, is whether or not you have the pizzazz.
Stop looking at Nick when you say
carry
that.
It off. if you haven't the confidence to carry it off, it's not going to come across at any age, so whatever you're wearing, as long as you feel comfortable in it and confident in it and you can carry it off. I think nowadays pretty much anything goes, I do think, maybe, again, looking at sort of down the female line, again, there could have been a way that you put on your makeup when you were sort of, in your, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. You've totally lost me now. No, putting on makeup a certain way, because makeup styles even change as well, Vinny. And that can be quite...
Contouring, Vinny.
Let's not go down this line.
I had a row with my niece in Primark, I'm not sure how you're meant to say it here, over a contour kit, which I thought was a big bunch of crayons. But then, I guess that's, Fionola, it's going back to that issue of when you mature and when times change around you, maybe you are more comfortable in a previous time. That nostalgia, it was what you know.
Yes, I suppose there is a familiarity, and yeah, the nostalgia and the comfort is all part of it. But then you don't want to go through life entirely being comfortable either. And there are many benefits to getting older, such as
when I say comfortable, I don't necessarily mean wearing baggy, well-fitting clothing and hush puppies and whatever else.
No, I know, I know.
Can I just say something here? Because I think a lot of this, you know, we're talking more about style than substance, really. And for me, it's about state of mind.
You've listened to the programme before. So,
well, yes, exactly. I came prepared. You see, you take my father, my late father, after he'd been widowed and he was in the early stages of dementia, he went on a trip to Lebanon and Syria before the recent trouble. It was probably the last trip that he made anywhere, really, and he was only just about able to keep himself together. He actually got arrested in Lebanon for taking photographs on a beach because there was a military installation there. And I'm lost, you know, to this day, I'm lost in awe at that's the sense of adventure that he still had at that age.
That's incredible.
I think if I was actually to, you know, say what age I have enjoyed the most, I would actually say my 40s. I have actually loved my 40s.
You're not in your 40s, Lindsay.
Vinny, stop. I was, you know,
Shane says you've been in your 40s for 15 years now. I had loved his mother.
The confidence that comes with being of a certain age, where you know, I've actually got to the stage where I was more self-conscious about obviously what I was wearing in my 20s, and now I'm actually at the stage where really it's not that you don't care what people think, it's actually a case of, you know, I like it.
Well, is it fair to say, Fionola, that women grow old from the head down? So we're talking shorter hair, like perms, maybe.
Nobody has perms
older,
anymore.
But older ladies, maybe it would be more popular. And then men grow old from the feet up, so comfortable, not very fashionable shoes. And then maybe like the Velcro things as well.
Velcro.
Is that fair?
And the stretchy waistbands, that's never good. Yeah.
And the big underwear.
Well, let's not even get into that.
No,
literally, let's not.
Do you know, actually, I think ironically, one of the silly things at the minute is I think you can actually sort of dictate what era you're in by your eyebrows.
What? That's not something that's occurred to me.
I mean, you know, if you actually look at fashion trends with eyebrows at the minute, it's a bit of a giveaway that you're not into the worms that are sitting across the top of your head. Now,
you are describing producer Seamus. That is basically, you go into the bathroom when you're getting ready for this show and he's basically drawing his eyebrows on. And then we talk about all this, and of course Nick, with his style, he completely blows it all out of the water. But, you know, and apparently he seems to tell me to ask if you wax your eyebrows, but I'm always nervous about saying things like that to Nick.
Who, me?
Yeah.
if you thread them, maybe, rather than wax, you see, threading would be the more in vogue.
And on that note, we will leave that. We're going to talk later on about becoming your parents, which I think ties into this. And maybe you've noticed some traits that your parents have or had that now you're adopting yourself, and maybe years ago you were embarrassed by that. We'll come back, 81771 on the text, after some more from Elvis.
We're calling.